Hello all, today I'm going to talk about DB2 SQL replication using ASMCLP command line. ASMCLP is the utility provided by IBM which will allow us to set up the replication without being going through GUI. The SQL replication uses the staging table, which means the data from the source is first inserted into the staging table, and from staging table it is applied onto the target. The queue replication is real time and it uses MQs, and it is slightly difficult to set up because you need to set up the queues first and you need to know the knowledge of how to the middle MQ component. Once you set up the MQ, the queue replication is easy to set up. In case of SQL replication, you do not need to set up the MQ and you can do everything into the DB2 using ASMCLP. So what I have done here is I got one database called dbcat. Now why cat? So what I'm going to do is instead of setting up the different source and different target database, I have set up the same table, same database as the capture and target. So in the same database I will be running the capture, in the same database I will be running the apply, and the apply is going to take the capture data and it is going to apply the target, which means the source and destination table is present under the same database called dbcat. So this particular database dbcat will contain the source table called employee and a target table called employee TGT, and using SQL replication, the data from employee from dbcat database will be replicated to employee TGT under the same database. So that's the aim. So this is the my setup will be just the employee table in dbcat, and we will be setting up the replication to set up the replication between employee to employee target. So let's go ahead. What are the steps involved? So these are the five steps involved in creating the replication. To create the replication, first you need to create the control tables for capture, then you will be creating the control tables for apply. Then you will be registering the sources. So you tell DB2 what is the source table, what is the table that you want to capture the data. Then you create the subscription set. Subscription set is nothing but a pair of the source and destination. And then you create the member in these subscription sets. You can have multiple members in the subscription set. So now let me repeat. You create the control tables for capture, you create the control tables for apply, you register the source, which is nothing but a table or a view, then you pair the source to destination, and then you create the members. So because I'm doing everything on single database, my capture will be also in dbcat, my apply will be also in dbcat, my source is employee, my target is employee TGT, so I'll be doing everything in the same database. So before going to that, what I will show you is I got this particular script. If I run, I'll show you. So okay, so let me go to scripts. Okay, let me clear the screen. Yeah, so I got this particular script, and in this particular script what I'm going to do is I'm going to drop this particular database, and then using this particular script I'm going to create a database. Now remember what this particular script does is it just creates a database, and after creating the database it actually sets it up into the archival mode. The remember that you cannot have your database in circular mode, it has to be in archival mode because the changes needs to be captured. The source database in the replication needs to be in archival mode. That is one of the requirements. Then after creating the database, I'm going to activate that particular database, connect to that particular database, and I'm going to create one table called employee, and under that particular table I'm going to insert one record, this particular record. And remember that I have defined primary key on this particular, which means this particular key will be used for the replication. So now that we have seen this particular script, let me run this particular script. So, okay, the drop was successful. So we have dropped the database. You see here, it is creating this particular database. The command that is ran is db2 create database dbcat. So it's going to create this particular database. While it is creating this particular database, what I will show you is how my ASN CLP script looks like. So I'll come here and okay. So as I said, my capture is also dbcat, my apply is also dbcat, and my target is also dbcat. So I have defined this. Then what I'm saying, set run script now, and if there is an error, stop. So run script now, and if there is an error, stop. Create control tables for capture. So now first step that I'm doing is, now I have set the capture. So in this particular database, create the control tables for capture. Then in this particular database, because I have set up this as a control, create control tables for apply. So once these two things are done, so we have now created the capture control tables and apply control tables. Then it is the third step, which is registration of the sources. So registration of sources. So here we say create registration. So we are registering this particular table, and we are saying differential, and the staging table is employee series. So this is the staging table. Now this is the substring set, which is the nothing but pair of your source and target, and in the substring set we'll be creating this member. So when I create the member, I'm saying in set name set 00, which is this particular set name. So I'm creating the members in this particular set name, and what I'm saying, activate the source, and from this particular table I want to target the data to this particular table. So now let's see. Okay, so the database is created. So let me connect to this particular database called dbcat, and let me show you the tables. So I have got this particular one table, and let me select the data from this particular table, and it should have one record. So this has one record. Now you see that we do not have the table called employee CD, neither we have table called employee TGT. The employee CD and employee TGT table will be created by this particular script. So this particular script is going to create the employee CD and employee TGT, and is going to first. So basically what this particular script will do is, like, it will connect to this particular database, create control tables, then it is going to connect to this particular database, is going to create apply control server, and then it is going to set up the replication between capture and target. So from between this database and this database, it's one of the same, but just for safety, just for knowledge, I'm specifying that from between this and this database is going to set up the replication, and it's going to register this particular source. So as you can see here, there is only one table. So now what I'll do is, in this window I'm going to run this, and to the way to run this particular thing script is ASN CLP. Look at the that you specify minus F, and then you specify the script name. So you are saying run these commands in this particular script using ASN CLP, and this is the file name. So this particular file name, the commands within this particular file, run them using ASN CLP. So let me run those commands. So it's running. Okay, so everything seems to be completed successfully, and we have got action running, completed successfully, which means looks like our aim or our script has worked fine. And now if I go here, and here there was only one table. Now if I run this, now you see I have got employee. So from one table I got these three tables, and what this is the main table, this is the change data or staging table, and this is the target table. Now what I'll do is I will select the data from the target table. So let me clear the screen, let me con to the same database, and let me select from employee, and let me select from target. So you see the target does not have the data as of now. So what it has done, it has set all the definitions, but the replication is still not started. So the replication between employee and employee TGT has not started. What I will do now is I will launch another window. So duplicate session. Okay, so and here I will launch db2rc, which is the replication center. Okay. Okay, so let me not do it here. Okay, so this is the db2 replication center, and now if I go under SQL application, if I say definitions, then I don't have any definition, and if I go on capture, I do not have any capture server. So what we will do is we will register our control server. So add server alias, so dbcat, so that's the database that we want to register. So, and user ID is db2p, password is db2p. Finish. So now we have got capture control server, which is dbcat. Now we will register our capture control server, which is also, in our case, it's a dbcat, because I have registered the apply and capture on both on the same server. Okay, fine. Cancel. Miss. Okay. Okay, so it looks like it has already. Okay, so okay, I should have done it here. I was doing it a long place. Okay, so you see, I have got dbcat under capture and dbcat under apply. And if I show you the register tables, I got this register table called employee. And the CD table will be employee CD. So this is my CD. And if I show you supreme set, then I got set 00. And under set 00, I got this capture control, which is also dbcat. And the apply is also dbcat. So this is apply and this is capture. Now, this is the register table. And what I can't see here is, okay, dependent targets. Yeah. Dependent target is from source table employee. I will be replicating the data to employee TGT. So, but if you see, the right now it is not activated. My replication is not activated as of now. And that is the reason the data is still not being replicated. So if I run select star, the data is still not being replicated to TGT. What I need to do is, now I need to actually start my replication. So I need to start the capture and then I need to start the apply. So to do that, I need to run. Okay. So I need to run ASM cap command, and I need to specify the capture server, and then I need to run ASM apply, and I need to specify the control server. This is not correct. I'll correct this. The capture server in our case is dbcat, and the apply control server is also dbcat. So I'm going to run both of these command together. Give it a minute, because I said sleep 5. So now let's see if both are running. So looks like both are running. So let me clear. And so what are we saying here is capture server dbcat start mode code and start the ASM cap, and also start the ASM apply for control server dbcat. So we have started our capture and we have started our apply. Now that we have started our capture and apply, let's go to target and let's see if our data has come into target. So you see here, employee target had no records, and now this particular employee target has got this one record. If I now go to my replication center and if I refresh this, okay, it is okay, for some reason it is not showing me green. Okay, fine. So what I will do now is, so this is employee and this is employee TGT. What I will do now is I will insert one record in employee. I will insert one record in employee and we will give some time for that particular record to appear into our target. So now that we have inserted this particular record, I will sleep for 10 seconds and then I will run this particular command. I just wanted to tell you that SQL replication is not real time. It takes a bit of time. The queue replication is instantaneous. You insert the record. Okay, so the second record seems to have appeared in the employee target, which is Mahesh R. So our replication is pretty much working. The insert happened in table employee and that record appeared in employee target. We could keep doing this. So I can set up another record. So let me set up another record called Ravindra and then let me run it for target. So let's sleep for 10 seconds and let's see output of target. Okay, so here it has not appeared. Let's sleep for another 10 seconds. Still not. Still not, surprising. 30 seconds already passed. Very much surprising. 40 seconds already passed. Let's see if our replication is up. Yeah, it is still running, so that should be fine. So okay, so you see the time that it has taken is close to a minute to appear for this particular record. It has taken a minute, but it has got replicated. So SQL replication is not real time. I could have shown this in queue replication, but my queue replication is currently down. I have to start it up. So the point that I want to make is SQL replication is, although it is easy to set up, so what we have done to set up this is simply the steps that I followed. I'll just show you. So I said my capture server is this particular database, my control is apply control is this particular database, my target is this particular database, set run script now, create control tables for capture, create control tables for apply, create a registration, create a subscription set and create a member. So this was all that I did. So these five statements did the magic of creating these particular two tables, but it only set this definition. It did not start the replication. To start the replication, I have to start the ASN cap program and ASN apply program. And here I need to specify what is my capture server and what is my control server. Once I start these particular data, programs, they will keep running as long as I don't stop them. So they will keep running as long as I don't stop them, and the whatever data is inserted into my source table, that would be replicated to, so whatever is in my source table, that will be replicated to TGT, and we have seen that in real time. I hope this video was useful. Do pass in comments. Before closing the session, I'll just show you what are the steps. So you create the control tables for capture, you create the control tables for apply, you register the source, you create the subsystem set, and you create the member. I hope this video was useful. Do pass in the comments, and thanks for watching. Bye bye.